Hi, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Place Value 2, Hundreds and Thousands. Did you know that we work with a number system called a base 10 number system? In this system, each number is made up of digits that hold a special value within a number. In this video, you'll learn about the place value of hundreds and thousands. Here we go! Before watching this video, be sure you have watched and understood place value 1, ones and tens. We have a base 10 number system, meaning each digit in a number has a value of 10 times the place to its right. This number is made up of individual digits, 1, 2, 3, 4. Together, they form the number 1,234. Each digit holds a special place in this number and has a different value from the one beside it. That means some of the digits are worth more than others, all depending on where they are placed within the number. To better understand the value digits hold, we need to look at a place value chart. Here is a place value chart. Remember, when looking at place value, we work from the right side to the left side. From video 1, you'll remember we have the ones place and the tens place. But since numbers are infinite, or go on forever, there are other places in the place value chart. Here is the hundredths place and the thousandths place. A place value chart doesn't end here. The chart continues just like numbers continue on infinitely. If we place this number on a place value chart, we place the digits from right to left. Now, when we look at the chart, we can see that the 4 is in the ones column, the 3 is in the tens column, the 2 is in the hundreds column, and the 1 is in the thousands column. If we read this number aloud from left to right, it's 1,234. But what does all of this really mean? Let's look at some numbers to figure out what value just one digit in the number holds. What does the number mean? If you remember in video 1, we used base 10 blocks to represent numbers. We can do the same here. 234 can be represented by 234 individual blocks. But can you imagine counting 234 individual blocks? Yikes! Luckily, the base 10 system is a neat system that allows us to count and also represent numbers in a neat fashion. So, you remember that a place value chart shows the ones, tens, and hundreds. The number 234 has 2 hundreds, 3 tens, and 4 ones in it. This means there are 4 individual units, 3 groups of 10 units, which can be shown by grouping individual units into 3 strips of 10, and 2 groups of 100 units, which means that 100 individual units are grouped into blocks like these. This represents 200. 200 plus 30 plus 4 equals 234. We can figure out place value without a place value chart at all. In fact, everyday numbers are not actually sitting on a place value chart, but we know each digit has a different value just the same. Let's look at this number. Remember, we work from right, or ones, to the left. In this number, 8 is in the ones place, 7 in the tens, or 70, and 6 in the hundreds, which represents 600, and 5 in the thousands place, or 5,000s. What is the value of 6 in the hundreds place? That's right, 600. Now let's try some other numbers without the chart. Can you figure out what number is in the hundreds place on each of these numbers? Let's count back to the hundreds place in 6,321. ones, tens, hundreds. The digit in the hundreds place is 3 or 300. Now let's do the same for the next number. In 486, the digit in the hundreds place is 4, so we say there are 4 hundreds in this number. This was a valuable lesson in place value because most of math has to do with how much a digit is worth. You can keep practicing place values with our fun online games and quizzes. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.